Hall of Fame member Judy Rankin. Let's take a look at some highlights from what we've already seen today. And we start with Trish Johnson here.
This should be a good look back up the hill towards this whole location. She knew it right away. Par will keep her two behind.
May hear Trish occasionally on Golf Channel.
Little cut up with her, and I did not realize who it was.
Out of context, maybe.
Great shot.
We're used to seeing Beth with the clubs, not necessarily carrying them, but that a great leave. And she's been close multiple times. Very nice.
Still has a lot of strength in her golf swing. Always did fire the ball high.
And we'll go out to Trish Johnson here for another birdie at 10. And that one just running out of speed. Had a great chance to win the senior LPGA championship. Triple bogey the final hole. Angela Stanford was the champion. There's a slightly different age. Trish Johnson second at the 12th. 57 years of age, Trish. Trish now for a birdie is to get it to 4 under par, tied the lead. And no, it looked like it was going to drop. It's going to be right on the edge.
I thought you called it.
That's not going to drop.
That the women's golf is getting some of the attention that it has deserved for quite a long time.
We saw Trish Johnson hole out for bunker on the 6th earlier. Not quite as good, but a well-executed bunker shot. We saw Trish Johnson's bunker shot to this point. Ooh.
Boy, and you could see her just come up and out of that, you know, eighth of a second too quick. They just walking back to our hotel, and there they were in their front yard.
Trish Johnson for a birdie at 14. Golf is part of the fabric of life there.
Yes.
Okay.
She knew she fanned it a little bit to start. Didn't quite have enough.
Haunted her the last two, maybe 3 years.
Trish Johnson, birdie putt on the way. Oh, and in.
Trish Johnson on the tee. Heading left down towards the tee and maybe the penalty area there. That is close. This is the 16th. It looks like Trish is just far enough away from the wood there not to have an issue and may get away with a par. Yeah, good three in the end. It looked like she could be in big trouble with that tee shot. She walks away with a par.
That's an impressive golf swing.
Now Trish Johnson, a little higher lofted club coming in here. Get over that front portion of the green.
What excitement there was both at Cherry Hills and at Bel Air. Out to 17.
This for eagle. An outright lead. And we've seen a couple of players of her, which is this group, Trish Johnson, now for birdie.
Yeah.
And that will take her to 4 under and currently tied for the lead.
18th hole. changes the angle a little bit with this up tee. She lobs that.
Yeah.
Great. Nice shot. Go for miles, but just stays in the fairway.
Oh my, that is way out there.
Trish Johnson going for the green in two.
The ball maybe is just ever so slightly below your feet as you play to the 18th green.
Now Trish Johnson, this is her third at the par five. I'm going to get over the ridge. And this for a birdie. So it's just going to be a par. She'd be disappointed to walk away with a five here.
Well, I don't think she hit that poor a shot into the green, but, you know, it's one of those that had it gone 3 feet to the right instead of 3 feet to the left, she would have been putting for eagle.
It'll be a big day tomorrow. That's the low round of the championship so far. Wonderful effort, 67 today. And one off the low.
Long bunker shot. This hole all the way at the back right part of the green. And that was a conservative play. Not happy with that. Caught it a little heavy. Slightly uphill and then flattens out.
Final day here at Waverley.
Trish going with a wedge and pulling that, not hitting that well at all. She really hit that thin.
Some of the celebrities say, isn't she a professional?
Who happens to be in the Hall of Fame?
Exactly. Trish not quite getting the read right there, Kay.
Well, from that distance, that was an unlikely putt to make. It was tricky with the left to right break.
Big mistake though when you miss the green with a wedge in your hand. Well, she moved through that shot with her legs.
And caught it really heavy.
Yeah, you were looking for some form of a solid strike on the golf ball.
Basically a 40-yard shot.
And now Trish Johnson for her par save.
Pretty slow uphill putt for par. And that looks like it's going to be three bogeys in four holes for Trish.
Course is playing very challenging today.
And yesterday she had a magical front nine shooting 4 under 32. This flirting with the left trees.
Well, she got through that beautifully though, and it's going to end up in the rough, but there was a little steam on it.
Third at the eighth for Trish Johnson.
Decent lie out of the rough, good angle from the left side. That's a gap wedge. Trying to get it to hit and release a little.
Trying.
27 footer uphill. A little left to right. Trish quickly walks after all her shots, good or bad. Then she does actually hitting them these days. She's quite a good commentator.
Yeah, I ran into her in the clubhouse earlier and she said, you know, this job, i.e. the commentary job, is a lot easier than being out on the golf course, you know.
Trish didn't like that. Has not really struck a very solid shot since the third hole, which she hit a wedge in tight and birdied there. Yeah, uphill, maybe a little sliding motion to it.
Around that putt a long time, maybe just enough time to take a deep breath.
That was back of the cup with authority, no doubt.
uphill, almost a little double breaking putt.
See if she can get another one to drop here. Okay. And they will head to the very difficult par 3, 11th.
A bogey or worse. She's pulled this. Oh, and it doesn't get onto the collar, and it drops down into that deep grassy bunker. I thought it would be easier, but I didn't think it'd be that easy. Great shot.
This is the tee shot at the 12th for Trish Johnson.
Going with less than driver because the fairway bunker on the right comes into play. It's an uphill blind tee shot.
And it is a very good one.
See if Trish decides to take this flag stick on with a 9-iron.
Well, she certainly can spin the ball.
And we'll certainly hit this a little higher and softer. Yeah, really, really well done. Leaves a stress-free par. If you're not going to make birdie, you want an easy two putt. Trish drove it in the right fairway bunker off the tee yesterday, and it led to a bogey. And this heading to the right side towards that where the bunker is.
No problem as long as she goes ahead and plays the shot.
She caught it. It hit and disturbed the club, but she got away with it. And most importantly, she got it up the steep slope at the front of the green and has a reasonable chance.
And it's a good look at what Trish was dealing with. And we've got Ryan Farb here from the USGA, an official.
Waverley, as we go back to 13.
Up the hill for Trish Johnson and her birdie attempt.
She's very animated, lives and dies a little bit with every shot.
She's a great interview. I really enjoyed chatting with her yesterday after the round.
Yeah, just one par four in the last six holes. That's at the 15th. This is the tee shot at 14 for Johnson.
With the pitching wedge in hand, did not get a good bounce off that side slope. Came in hot. And she has a big wave to putt up and over, then will be speedy at the end. Has some right to left break. Well, this has a pretty good line, and wow, can't believe that came up short.
Oh, right,
it continues to be so.
Yeah, really good there. That was not an easy putt, as you saw with the amount of break.
Trish, 9 times out of 10, going with driver off the tee. And I think it's a good choice because this plane uphill is going to play quite long. She's going to try to avoid that bunker on the right side. But this fairway tilts right to left. Just ideal. You couldn't ask for a better number in. 110 yards. She's got a wedge in her hand.
Oh, wow. That's a statement right there.
It is tough to pick who's going to be the champion in the end.
And
Brandy plays with almost every vertebrae in her back fused. It's an amazing story.
Trish Johnson's tee shot at 16.
That was an 8-iron.
It's
so hard to see with the kind of the smoky air and the reflection off the. Oh. She stayed so solid over that putt.
That's a big moment there for Trish.
Well, this having quite a bit of hook, it may find that last bunker on the left. Looks like it might have held up short. That was very fortunate. She's probably going to try to land at 205 and let it scoot back. But she's pulled this, and it looks like it ended up in that front left bunker the same.
May not actually be a sand wedge. She might play this with a pitching wedge or a 9-iron.
Oh, not going to do it. I'm going to watch that curl all the way back down and leave her, goodness, some, oh, wow, I'm going to leave her a good, at least 30 paces to the hole. You know, because it lost momentum. See if she, oh, I think she whiffed that one. She didn't hit that solid at all. And that happens sometimes when you try to hit it really hard, you end up missing the sweet spot. And maybe a little decel in that stroke. And lo and behold, a six. She needed it.
And it just drift into the rough.
Kept that down, kind of driving it through that little breeze that's hurting.
Wasn't quite a step through, but she was after it the minute she made contact.
What did you make of that exchange there between caddy and player?
And a reminder to keep it short right of the hole. That looks like what she's done. Oh, gorgeous. Gorgeous.
And finally, it is her championship. Trish Johnson is the U.S. Senior Women's Open champion. And this will mean so much to her. Time for the champagne.
Helen Alfredson. Patricia. Katrin Nilsmark. All friends.
Trish, that trophy looks just perfect in your hands. You've played in all five of these U.S. Senior Women's Opens. Second, third place finish, 15th, 12th. How does champion sound to you?
Oh, mate, I am so knackered, I've got to be honest. Just amazing, honestly. It is, it's something I've always wanted to do, whether it, any USGA event, never even came close in a regular US Open. Had a, well, no, not really, oh, maybe had a bit of a chance when Alfie won. But apart from that, never really in with a shout. And today, after the front eight holes, I thought, here we go again. Not going to, but rallied a bit and hit some decent shots coming in. Beanie got a bit unlucky a couple of times coming in, and here we are.
Well, you talked about that front nine. You got off to a stellar start, hit every fairway and green, one under after three holes, then three bogeys in a four-hole stretch. Your driver went a little AWOL. How did you collect yourself and head to the back nine? Well, you ended up birdieing 9 and 10 and really turned things around.
Yeah, it went a little bit pear-shaped there on the fourth, and all sorts of trouble. I think actually the up and down at four for a bogey was massive, really. And then I hit some pretty average shots all the way into nine, and I hold a really good putt on nine, which sort of got me a bit, you know, motivated again rather than miserable. And then I hit some good iron shots. I made a really good up and down at 11 as well. How I've got out at 11. Level par for the week, I'll never know, because I looked at that hole and I thought, yeah, this is going to get me without a shadow of a doubt. But gutsed it out, really. It wasn't brilliant today. It was good yesterday. I hit some good shots, but I hit some ropey ones as well. And I got away with it, really.
I look forward to you sharing some stories with some of the members afterwards. You were in contention to win a senior LPGA championship, and things went terribly wrong on the last hole. You made a triple and lost. What did you learn from that championship that you were able to put into play here, particularly come down the stretch when things got a little tight?
I think that all happened so quickly. I had a three-shot lead with two holes to play, and it was, you know, that sort of feeling of 20 minutes has gone, and can I just replay that? Because I don't quite know how that all happened. And obviously Angela shot 7-under as well, so it's a combination of both. But, yeah, I was pretty gutted to finish so poorly. But I wasn't playing as well that week as I did this week, and I wasn't hitting my driver very well that week. And apart from a couple of them today that were a bit dodgy, the driver was really, you know, quite good, so gave me plenty of opportunities. And really the answer to your question in a roundabout way is breathe. Just keep breathing. And Beth kept, my caddy was brilliant, kept giving me water every 2 seconds. I think she could see the, you know, the colour draining out of my face. Didn't want me to faint in front of everybody. So she was fantastic you know, a big part of why I won this week.
Beth, quite an accomplished player in her own right, and I'm sure she helped keep you calm. What was it about Waverley Country Club that spoke to you and allowed you to play such great golf?
Do you know, I think this golf course is possibly one of the best conditioned golf courses I've ever played in my entire career. Ever.
And you've played a lot of golf.
I played a lot of golf. And by the way, the greens are nuts, but I'm still going there. But it was just in such fantastic condition. And I don't know, there's something about it. When I aesthetically love the look of a golf course, when it really, you know, is looks so gorgeous, I tend to play quite well. I have no idea what the reason is for that, but when I saw it, I actually thought me and Laura talked about it after we played a practice round and said, if you shoot level par around here, you're winning. And that's what we thought, but you forget how good the players are, and you know how much guts they've all got, and everybody just competitive, you know, how competitive everybody is. And that, you know, led to sort of, you know, under par scores, which I think around here is flipping brilliant.
You had a terrific amateur career, played on Curtis Cup, World Amateur Team. You won the British Amateur. You had a great, stellar pro career, really, 19 wins on the LET. Where does this stack up, speaking to your longevity and what kind of golf you're playing at this age, 50-something?
57, yes. Do you know, I think because, I mean, you know, I do some commentating, a little bit of commentating, a little bit of studio stuff, and I think watching the girls on the LPGA and the LET, and the standard is so incredibly, you know, there's so many talented players that I enjoy it so much, and then I want to go out and practice. And, can't compete, obviously, with those guys, but it makes me really want to compete. And I think that never leaves you. You know, you lose your ability to hit shots or whatever, but you never lose your competitive spirit. I think that's really helped me by, you know, commentating on those guys. I get really excited when I come out on a golf course and think, oh, so-and-so hit that shot. I wonder if I can't. Okay, well, I'll try another way. You know, and I think that's a big, big thing. So I really look forward to playing. And, you know, at the moment I'm playing well, and we all know golf is great when you're playing well, and it's misery when you're playing badly.
Well, I don't know. We might need to see you playing in the Solheim Cup next month instead of commentating.
Not in a million years. I did that 8 times, and that was my last one was 2007, and that was, I mean, unless you were playing great. But I tell you what, I love commentating on it because it's the absolute epitome of... I think people still have no idea how good the women are. They are unbelievably good. Anybody should be out there watching. And I think the Solheim Cup in Spain in a couple of weeks' time is going to be spectacular.
Well, you're unbelievably good. You've had a long career, and you finally win your first USGA championship. Enjoy that gold medal. Let's see you lift that trophy one more time. Congratulations, Trish Johnson.